cry, but when I'm not around, the tears flow easily. Kept out of sight, kept out of sight. You dry your face so nicely, so I only see a light. I'll not raise my voice, I'll not raise my voice, but I'll plant a seed of doubt so that you hang on my every choice. That's the price you pay, that's the price you pay. That's the kindest way of saying that your dreams have flown away. I say I don't know better, but we both know that I do. Your words can lift me from the customary blue. I'm sorry if mine were too hard for you to chew. I know I spat them out, but only half of them were true. Only half of them were true. This was something we'd just be tied into. In the simple talk, in the simple talk, the spark has now deserted us, so why should I not walk? It's the crack in your voice as you try to ascertain which parts of you I could never entertain, which parts of me tuned into your pain, and which parts of me that just listen in vain. Your dreams are only ever big enough for two. My dreams are born from other people passing through. Now they're a shadow of the visions that we drew. I think it's time we had another review. I think it's time we had another review. First be lonely if we're ever to be free.
Thank you. Good evening and welcome to the convent. Welcome to the first Gramophone Armageddon. It's lovely to have you here. It's lovely to have you guys here. Welcome, welcome. This is all about live music. Live music tonight by live bands. Enjoy the show. We'll see you later on. Enjoy the gig.
Tone that illuminates your phone, oh, born in haste. waste fades the image on which importance is placed. And you can feel it with its iron grip under the thumb. Just a quick fix and you know you're ultimately numb. Felt so cold. Eyes are faded, life invaded by any means, just admiration. Validation from your screens. To what end? If it's all pretend, if it's just a veil, and any notion of a friend's promotion will leave you pale. Sometimes wonder what's hiding under and where to start. A digital smile can take a while to pick apart. A digital smile can take a while to pick apart.
Hello, well, we got the gorgeous Fred Claridge on drums here. Give him a little hand. And you guys at home, give him a hand, please. And the equally gorgeous Jacob JJ Stoney on the keys. I think this is our third time back at the convent. Anyway, it's not important. It's lovely to be back. And we got a song that we're doing songs from my new album that we've just finished recording. It's out in May. And this is a song that I wrote about a Porsche that I fell in love with after me and Fred went in some chinos to a dealership in Mayfair, pretending that we could afford a car that we really, really couldn't afford. Sun beat down on Mayfair, on the golden heart of the town. You could tell it was touching the 30s by the glacial beads on his brow. The golden heart of the town, they said, in all its splendor and charm. But only gold is finery, your wallet has a firearm. To Marble Arch, rollers to drop top Benzes, but none of them tugged at the heart. As soon as his nose pressed the window of a German dealership, the bulbous eyes of a 356 caught him and never let slip. She doesn't turn with much conviction, and her toga leaks in the rain. But she comes with a boot full of stories about an innocence hard to contain. Ooh. at the door, entertained him, though his shoes were falling apart. It had been slow from behind the desk, and he had facts to impart. They looked at the engine together, air cooled and mounted in the rear. Flat four with dual carburetors, and thirsty in any gear. Just 40,000 on the clocks, he said, she'll go for quite a price. There's an oligarch around the corner who's been in to see her twice. But the secret lies in her age, he said, oh, doesn't she look sinless? You could park her outside the door to stir and get all the interest. Oh, she doesn't turn with much conviction, and a toggle leaks in the rain. But she comes with a boot full of stories, out of innocence hard to contain. And if I had the money, I'd release her from the chains. I'd drive her through the streets of Mayfair, turn round and do it all over again. Soon came time for closing, hoping it wouldn't be for good. He bid adieu to the doorman, and the sky shone red as her hood. He looked up and started dreaming of a 356 of his own, as he mounted his bike and set off for the east side of town by Marylebone. One day. Screens with the baggage only great beauty brings. I knew I needed her by any means. First encounter, I was on my guard. The second saw me open up more. By the third, my eyes were no longer starred. I was hooked, and I needed number four. She treads a path often then brings me along, brings me along like never before. She's in town for the night, but I just can't drag myself outside. Though a part of me hopes that maybe I just might. I know my hands are tied. Tied 'cause you bound them together. Touch of a feather, I'm unworthy of. You know they'll fall when your eyes are shining. Temper your smiling unless you're looking for love. Found this guitar hanging up backstage, and I just thought it was so nice I had to play it tonight. So thank you for being here. I already have one guitar on loan from the convent, actually, so I should probably have this snatched out of my hands before I nick it. This song called Castello. queen of the castle, but she wears no crown. Stones are silver, gilded gown. Can anybody help her hang this endeavor so she can see every change? The view of another was never clearer. The view of a selfish strange. She'll roam south in someone else's car, armed with a dream and a DSLR. I wonder if she fears the city, or will she translate with ease? I wonder if she's ever been viewed with pity, even in boots like these. She did a year in Manchester, and it rained every other day. The Balkan half of her gave it heart, the Latin half gave way. They tried to get her onto Joy Division. She said she liked the feel, but it lacked precision. She soon got bored and took the decision to listen to James instead. I think she thinks it helped her cleanse, seeing stone through a rainy lens. I know I'll never know half the story, but it doesn't leave me flat. I know she smiled when she first saw me. I think I can live with that. Oh, she greeted me at the fortress with a smile and an open palm. It's all as old as the stones around it, with easily twice the charm. A right hand man took his lens cap, slipped it in his fitted jeans, said the light was perfect and immortalized the scene.
We got one more song for you, called Phoenix, which closes the new album, and then you can get on to all the other great artists that are on tonight. That wasn't implying that we're great, just there are other great artists. We are an artist. Anyway, moving on. Actually, it's my show really, isn't it?
Some say they've seen her flying overhead, but they've never found her nest. And keeping her young watered and fed, in her shadows you'll be blessed. I've heard them say that somewhere along the line, never by her design, the embers turn to ashes, and she's up there, colors running red and golden. I'm seeing her rise. And do you see half the pain that she's enduring? I can see it in her eyes. Apollo came down to listen at the well, couldn't resist her song. Left left his chariot by the road where she fell. When he got there, she was gone. If gods are taking note, they're at each other's throats. But she's seen this before. But she's seen this before.
Television before, but this is different in this way, and good.
And it's good that it's all a part of your tours as well.
Yes, we're out there. We're on Friday. We're doing a pop up concert in Worcestershire.
At the Ale House.
At the Ale House, and then we're in Devon on Saturday, in King's Co as well. And but this is a little gem for us.
Yeah, it's very cool. Yeah. Convent, really cool.
How's your tour going, Emma?
It's good. I wouldn't really call it a tour, really. I don't think I'm really touring, but I'm doing lots of gigs around festivals in the summer and stuff like that. But it's good. We're busy. But this is really cool. It's a good setup. And it's nice and friendly. It's amazing when you're touring, so it's good.
What have you been up to recently? Have you been writing any new music? Or?
Yeah, I've been doing some really cool collaborations with loads of different writers, which has been really fun. Good material coming out on that, hopefully releasing some this year. Don't know when exactly, but it's sounding good. So, yeah.
What sort of artists have you been working with?
A cool writer called Emily Phillips. She's been good. We wrote a track with her a couple of weeks ago. She wrote Risen Pits album.
Nice.
So she's pretty cool. Phil Bested. Chasing Bass, he was cool, wrote really cool stuff, finished writing really cool stuff with him. And then a few other people as well, and it's just fun, collaborating, it's good fun meeting all the people.
What inspires you when you're writing with them? Do you have any sort of events that you go by, or daily things that you do?
I think, just life observation, I guess. But I think I like making up stories to go with the songs. So it's always fun to talk about the stories and develop them with different people and make up like random stuff. But they don't always have to be like my real life things, because I haven't got enough real life events to write about.
That's where the creative side comes out of it, isn't it? To sort of like make things up.
Your imagination comes.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
So you can be a novelist too, can't you?
Yeah.
That's all a part of it.
Yeah, you don't have to write about things you know about necessarily. People always say you should, but there's plenty there, isn't there?
Yeah.
You can.
Which is funny because I'm rubbish at GCSE English.
Oh. I know, but who cares?
And Charlie. So sort of what inspires you when you're writing your music or playing? Or?
Well, it's normally I'm usually lyric driven initially. There has to be, when I'm writing for myself, it has to be an idea that comes from in here. When I write for other people, I try and make myself invisible, if you like, and write something that is very much to do with them. So I'm kind of invisible, like a ghostwriter. But for me, the idea has to come first. And sometimes there'll be, if you get lucky, you can be sitting at the piano and a little phrase will come out along with a little sequence of chords. And then generally what happens is, if that happens, then I carry on, finish the music, and then carry on with the rest of the words. So it's like doing a crossword puzzle in the end. You know, I've got 40 across and 3 down, and I've got to fit the 2. And so, there's something happening behind me. There was something strange.
I think there might be something happening.
I shouldn't have had that mushroom
nothing.
Soup. Did you
no.
have a mushroom soup?
I did have a mushroom soup.
A couple
soup.
Of ghosts here.
Nothing strange happens here. Nothing strange happens here. Well, thank you ever so much for joining me in the boardroom. I look forward to seeing your performance later. Thanks, guys.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
Thanks.
Myself from ending up like this. I need an explanation. Is there some kind of complication up there in my head that needs to be fixed? 'Cause I'm running out of time. Right now I need you more than anything, so please don't leave me behind, 'cause you're my only lifeline. You're my only. And I had a plan, but I lost it, see. Somewhere in the oceans that you cried over me. So don't you ever, don't you dare blame it on me. Don't you ever, don't you dare. Why can't you see that I'm running out of time? Right now I need you more than anything, so please don't leave me behind. You're my only lifeline. You're my only lifeline. You're my only lifeline. You're my only lifeline. Don't leave me behind. I need a home. 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 'Cause I'm running out of time. Right now I need you more than anything, so please don't leave me behind, 'cause you're my only lifeline. You're my only lifeline. You're my only lifeline. You're my only lifeline. Don't Don't leave me behind on your lifeline. Don't leave me behind on your lifeline. Don't leave me behind.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Emma McGrath. This is cool. That was Lifeline, and the next song I'm going to play is my single, and it's called Sit With Me. Is it the silence that scares you, or is it the light? You might come across if you just close your eyes. And is it the truth that scares you, or is it the lies that you keep telling yourself so that you feel fine? I just think there's something, something you're not feeling, 'cause you don't believe it. Yeah, I just think there's something, something you're not feeling, even though you know it's there. So just sit here with me, close your eyes, let the world just pass you by. Feel your heart, your breathing, but don't say a word. And is it for personal reasons or to please someone else? 'Cause you say that you don't care, but I think you do. I've got a lot of feelings, but I feel them all. 'Cause it's bad to look them up for when you fall. And I just think there's something, something you're not feeling, 'cause you don't believe it. Yeah, I just think there's something, something you're not feeling, even though you know it's there. Just sit here with me, close your eyes, let the world just pass you by. Feel your heart, your breathing, but don't say a word. Oh, just sit here with me, close your eyes, let the world just pass you by. Feel your heart, your breathing, but don't say a
like to welcome back to the couch Blair Dunlop and Jack Henderson. Blair Dunlop Band, I'd like to re-say that, not just Blair. How'd you guys find it?
Yeah, it's good fun. It's, our third time back at the convent, so it's our old stomping ground. But it's a really cool new format, so yeah, lovely to open a show.
So tonight you played some new songs?
Yes, off the new album. Let's get that plug in there. From our upcoming album, Gilded. And we finished recording it quite recently, but it's a quick turnaround. It's out in May, and we're on tour through April and May to
Town near you.
Sell it. Yeah, to a town near you. Yeah.
Nice. I haven't actually heard you speak yet. Tell me a little bit about yourself. How did you meet Blair? Put you on the spot.
My name's Fred Claridge, and I met Blair through the guy that produced Blair's first two albums, Mark Hutchison. He got me in on the band after Blair's second album, and then we've just made Blair's third album and just about to tour that.
Nice. And then you guys bonded from that, then, did you? And now you're best friends forever.
I wouldn't say bonded.
We suffered each other.
It's a professional relationship.
We've been told to stop, I think.
Thank you for joining me on the couch again, guys. It's time for Charlie Dore.
I try to live forever, but I won't. butter in the sun till this world turns into butter in the sun.
We're going to swap around now, and we're going to this is Gareth Hugh Davis, and this is Mr. Julian Lippman.
Evening.
My co-pilots this evening, and we're going to do a song that we've never done before, ever, and it's Julian will tell you about it while I go to the piano.
Off she goes. There you go. It's a song that Charlie wrote with Jimmy Nail. It's called "Ain't No Doubt." Anyone know it? Don't know. We've stripped it back to, we brought it back home to how she wrote it. So this is Ain't No Doubt.
Okay. Time, a little space, a place to find myself again. You know, I know a goodbye when I hear it, and he smiles, but his heart's already out there walking down the street. He says, I don't want nobody else, he's lying. I don't need nobody else, he's lying. Say you'll always be my friend, he's lying. What does he pretend? Ain't no doubt, it's plain to see. A man like you's no good for me. If your heart's beating at another door, I'm a dumb fool to ask for more. He said it's like in the song, remember? If you love somebody, set them free. Well, that's how it is with me. You know, I'll always come back. He kisses me, and somewhere I hear a door slam. He says, I don't want nobody else. He's lying, there won't be nobody else. Always be my friend, he's lying. Why does he pretend?
Ain't no doubt, it's plain to see. A man like you's no good for me. If your heart's beating at another door, I'm a dumb fool to ask for more.
I don't want nobody else.
love you, there won't be nobody else. I love you, I don't need another friend. I want you, no need to pretend.
Ain't no doubt, it's plain to see, a man like you's no good for me. If your heart's beating at another door, I'm a dumb fool who asks for more. I'm a dumb fool who asks for more.
Thank you. This is a song about IVF.
Waiting in the petri dish, anonymous, our greatest wish. I wonder, will you ever see 100 men in their white coats, from Land's End up to John O'Groats, defy biology. When I think of all the years we spent, the ways, the means to just prevent you, now the final irony, the secret love we made at night, now distilled in broad daylight for everyone to see. But some things are never meant to be. Could it be? Who could you be? You could be 2 yards tall. You could be beautiful. You could be plain, so plain. You could be anyone. You could be our best chance. You could refuse the dance. You could be all these things. All these things are nothing. All these things are nothing at all. We've read the maps, we know the ropes, we know to never get our hopes up. Who would bet with hearts so low? So I don't blink when choirs sing or linger over tiny things. That way we never go. For some things are never meant to be. But could it be? Could it be? Who could you be? You could be 2 yards tall. You could be beautiful. You could be plain, so plain. You could be anyone. You could be our best chance. You could refuse the dance. You could be all these things. All these things are nothing. All these things. You could be a saint or sinner, chaos maker, spit your dinner. You could make us proud. Stride in like a giant, crash the car, or be compliant. Complicated, clear as water, billionaire or begging chorus. You could be a son or daughter. A 100 men in their white coats, from Land's End up to John O'Groats, defy, defy biology.
Thank you.
Charlie Dorn.
We are in the boardroom, and here with me I have Blair Dunlop Band and Jack Henderson. Welcome.
Thanks for having us. Thanks for having us.
It's an absolute pleasure to have you here. So Blair, talk to me a little bit about your tour so far.
It's not started yet.
It's not started.
No.
So
this is a kind of a pre-tour little event with the Convent, which is we love it here. So it's brilliant. We're going to preview some stuff from the new album that we've got coming out in May, and we'll be touring that in April and May, just doing all over the UK. And yeah, it's a perfect place to start doing the new stuff, really.
Definitely. If you could tell me a little bit more about your new album that's coming out in May.
Okay, it's called Gilded, and it's just got these two reprobates on it. and we recorded it up in Manchester at Blueprint Studios. We had a great time over December, didn't we? Well,
yeah, it was great.
I had a great time. Yeah.
Are you sure you had a good time?
Yeah, it's just all new material. Thematically, it's, I don't know, like gilding is kind of dressing yourself up to be something that you're maybe not sharing different sides of the human facets that you want to portray to other people, not necessarily truthful. So, I'm unprepared.
And what inspired you to go down that route?
Well, when I first started playing, gigging around, I did quite a lot of trad stuff, and I've always been really influenced by traditional music, particularly British traditional music. But as I did more gigging and started playing with different people, I wanted to do my own stuff and sing my own songs, and so the last album was a progression of that, and then this again, still got quite a lot of folk influences, and I like ballads, I like stories, and there's still quite a lot of that. But I like all kinds of music. As a musician, you've got to be into all kinds of music to appreciate it. It's fair to say that goes for most musicians. You've got to be influenced by a range of stuff. So it's got folk elements, but it's a little bit more singer-songwritery. With a bit of these guys.
With a bit of these guys. Yeah.
But mainly me.
It's just all you.
Yeah.
Jack.
Hello.
Hello. Hello in the corner. How are you doing?
I'm good.
How's your tour going? Do you have a tour at the moment?
Or
is this
a
special event?
I have a tour at the moment. This is a special event. I've probably got a couple of tours not coming up till the autumn. Between now and then is sporadic events, of which this is one. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to is it preview? You're going to preview songs off your album that's not out. If I've got an album that's just come out, am I post-viewing them? I'm not really sure what they are, but I feel like I'm previewing them. Mm. Anyway, so I'll do a few songs off there tonight. Yes. Yeah.
Are you doing the one that you did last night?
No.
Oh.
You're not?
Man, I love that.
That's not on the record. That's about 87 years old. It's an old song.
So in your 87 years?
In my 87 years as a professional.
Tell me a little bit about your new album.
The one that's just done?
Yes.
We recorded it in New York with some absolutely stunning players on it. That I was in awe of. It's not very rare, actually. It's often that I'm intimidated by my own band. Whoever's playing with me, they're always better than me. But it's absolutely stunning to have some of those guys come in. It's just a dream come true. When you've already got a great producer and who's also a great bass player, and then he says, you know what, I'm not the guy to play on this track, I'm going to get Tony Garnier, Bob Dylan's bass player, in for this. It's like, what is going on here?
I want to be star of the show.
Well, no, it's just like, I mean, what an amazing position to be in, to have someone like that saying, I'll call this other guy. It's like, do what you're right. you go for it, yeah.
Thank you ever so much for joining me in here, guys, as much as I'd love to carry on talking to you.
Oh, I'd like you to have this.
Oh, I'd like to have this.
Nine-inch nail.
Nine-inch
nail. They got into it.
Yeah.
9-inch nails. Look forward to your performances later. Thank you for coming.
Cheers. Thank you. Thank you.
I'm a hopeless romantic, at least that's what I say. It's the perfect excuse for behaving this way. If I seem a shambles, I have to confess. I'm a hopeless romantic, but I'm one of the best. I'm a hopeless romantic, I don't have to try. I see the angels where you see the sky. I've been disconnected, I'm out of my mind. I'm a hopeless romantic, I'm one of a kind. I might disappoint you, I might disappear. I might say nothing for years. It's a kind of protection, it's a type of conceit. It's a kind of denial for a type of defeat. Disappoint you, I might disappear. I might say nothing for years. It's a kind of protection, it's a type of conceit. It's a kind of denial for a type of defeat. I'm a hopeless romantic, it's my only defense. Gotta hold on to something when nothing makes sense. The odds are against me, yeah, I have to admit. But I'm a hopeless romantic who forgot when to quit. I'm a hopeless romantic who forgot when to quit. Thank you very much. Baby's over the moon. What am I gonna do? I told her she was my one and only. It ain't true, but baby's over the moon. There's no picture in my wallet, and my tattoo safely keeps the secret my heart embraces. A long way from my sleeve. So where do I begin to keep this secret sin? When it's tearing me apart. I'd hate to be the one to watch her come under and leave her going down. I should confess, but I lack the confidence, and the moment never comes around. Now I'd hate to be the one to watch her come undone and leave her going down. My baby's over the moon. It's a good one, written just for me. And even now, the noose is growing tight. A note onto his coat, take the ribbon from his sleeve. Bring your paper mattress, 'cause who knows where we'll sleep. Underneath the bridges, and we'll ride the moon beneath our feet, where old men dance so they don't dream. Mm-hmm. be missing before they know we're gone. And we'll hide among the poets and the young. Act like we are lovers. No one will suspect. Keep the organ grinder guessing. Leave the hangman in suspense.
Let it go.
Do you know
that
bird
that
always sings
I'm a Barbie girl?
Do you know that?
Have you heard that bird sing
I'm a
Barbie girl?
The Barbie bird?
Barbie bird.
Barbie girl.
Singing.
Yeah, I know the Barbie bird.
The Barbie bird.
It's my favourite bird.
I don't know what.
Okay, good morning.
Okay.
Hello, we are in the boardroom and I have on my couch with me. Well, couch? It's more of a bench really, isn't it? I can't get away with saying that this time. It's Ida Venu. Did I get it right?
Yes.
How are you guys doing?
Good.
Good. Good.
You excited?
Get some food and some wine. And
perfect. And it's actually quite snuggly over here, isn't it, as well? So, you released an album in September.
Mm-hmm.
Could you talk to me about your album?
Of course, yeah. I released my album Time of Ghost, which was my first solo album. Before that, I had a band called Bobo Dancer. And so Time, of course, is in many ways kind of, yeah, you know, the debut album where I kind of show myself and the world that I could manage on my own and trying out a new, more minimalistic kind of approach to music and more playful also. And then, of course, I got these brilliant guys along the way.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Hello, guys.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Good.
Good. Looking forward to playing in that wonderful chapel like room.
Soundcheck sounded fantastic.
Yeah, it was
really
the sound on stage is just exquisite.
Seriously, it's like breathing up there. You're just like, oh,
rare.
And then things come out, music comes out.
Brilliant.
Sounded
really
beautiful.
Nice.
Your tour at the moment, how's it going?
We are on a tour at the moment. It's going really, really great. We have this show left and one at Greenhorn on Friday. And it's been so great so far. We've seen a lot of beautiful places and with a very dedicated audience, which you don't always see. And I think also for us, sometimes the UK get a bad reputation because as a musician you always talk about how you don't get treated well when you go there, you get no money.
We just
and
spoiled with it.
And look at this, you know. So we are definitely feeling good about being here, enjoying very much.
Yeah, that's what we're here for. It's an absolute pleasure to have you here anyway. We'll look forward to this evening's performance.
We are too.
Thank you.
I see you shaking,
I'm shaking too. Climbing walls that never end. Spirit trees are hanging low. I know you're breathing well. I know, I see you're breathing well. I am on your side. I am on your side. I am on your side. It's racing. I know it keeps you up at night. You search at every angle. I know we see things differently. As long as it's not separate.
With reason, but oh, I see.
Such a beautiful stage before. It is really incredible. The next song we're going to play for you is a song called Curtains. There's a little curtain over there, because it is actually about being on a stage like this, or at least feeling like you're on a stage like this, and you are two people on that edge and that edge of the stage, and you don't really know if you want to pass on to the stage and make some kind of a play together. Let's see how it goes.
Boy, you are in trouble now. Can't separate the facts
A simple touch is all you need. Ignite the chemistry. What's on your mind? Are we the kind that root, or are we drifting on the bridge? We looked at it. You pointed out the minefields. You released something beautiful. I like to tell you, but it's hard, you know. The stage is empty, and we're the act. There's nothing written and nothing said. It might be time. We'll pass through the curtains. The days go by. I write you now, but all the letters fade. There's so much space between the wave of thought and sound. How do you feel? How have you been? Is everything all right? This is real, the art of conversation. You release something beautiful. I like to tell you, but it's hard, you know. The stage is empty, and we're the act. There's nothing written and nothing said. It might be time. We'll pass through the curtain. It might be time to pass through the curtains.
Take a cab through the snow and